We'll be right back. Alrighty. Well, it looks like everything appears to be some kind of functioning order. And I might want to turn off that and turn on that. So yes, welcome to and welcome back to the live stream. My name is Ed, and yeah, just kicking off from where I was the previous night, I will be drawing this one as an animation. So I kind of got the idea of making Mr. Stay Puft way more dynamic than I currently did, with just the effects and everything, just to make it more fun and sort of, I guess, poppy. You'll just have to excuse me, I am definitely on a bit of a roll here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to animate the following. So I'm going to animate these these lightning bolts. I'll also animate the swirling of the storm vortex, the eye of the storm above him, and also the shadows, as well as make his I think it's like called a neckerchief or something like that, have that like sort of being blown by the wind, to make it look a bit more dynamic. So yeah, if you're just joining me, welcome to the live stream. And I'll be doing some animation today, because figured that would be a great place to kick it off. Now, I don't really need these backgrounds in here for now. I can actually get by with much less. Down the opacities on these layers, and what I'm gonna do is just sort of, I actually don't even need it to be colored at the moment, just gonna pencil in that out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have like this part here kind of like being blown by the wind, this part here being blown by the wind, and maybe like dancing shadows across his body. So make him look a bit more ominous. I'm not going to use that ink layer at the moment. So get these keyframes in. Alternate between the two. So on the I'm using this time to just take a bit of a break before the Christmas rush really sets in. And I am up inundated. I'm just going to change the color of this layer to blue, and this layer to green, and the next layer to orange. So I'm just get a general idea. What I'm doing here is it's an old hand-drawn animation technique called in-betweening. Just turn on animation assist. Just run that through its paces. That's running a bit too quickly, so what I'm going to do, just add a frame in between each one so it doesn't look like it's strobing too much. I mean, it's still strobing obviously, but it's nowhere near as chaotic. Next layer I'll just do in purple. And I'll have it coming down. Get this to give the appearance of it flying in the breeze, but also I want to be able to group these together. I'll turn on this guy here. Have his so I'll animate this. So if you see in like anime where like a character is standing still, like in a field or something like that, and like it's just nothing but the wind blowing through, this is basically that animation technique. So yeah, it's super easy. because it has to do with sort of fluid dynamics. Go to the next. I'll use a different shade. And depending on how like violent you want the wind to look, that's how many frames you actually want to like include. So like when the wind's very heavy and you see like it sort of rushing through the air and everything like that, dance a bit, turn down the opacity just a scotch, and another frame. And that's essentially all you need, is just like three basic keyframes, and you can just sort of eyeball the rest. Excuse me. I am still on the recovery train. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with how those have turned out. I'm just gonna group these in. Just give them a separate name. Collar. And I'll group these guys in. Call them, I don't know, I think it's a t I'm not sure what exactly what it's called. If someone knows what the name of the sailor's necktie is called. Necktie. Cool. Just bring this a little closer. What I'm doing. And the next animation I want to work on is his what's it called? This thing. A little tassel that comes off his hat. No. Always make sure. These are always slightly a different color. So don't get too confused. Alrighty. So I think I'm in a pretty decent spot to get cracking with the next stage. Now I might obviously do some reworks just in case the effect is not desirable. I think it's coming along rather smashingly, as I think about it. So my background's in animation. The first full-time job I had out of high school was with an animation studio. Like I'd done my work experience at a place that did stop motion animation. And that was pretty fun. I don't think they're around anymore though. I haven't checked. They might be operating under a different name, but I was, I think, 16 when I did some, I guess you could call it interning. And the weird thing was, like, you know, as a couple of high school, like, it was me and, like, one other guy from my year who was also into animation. And, you know, we just kind of hung out together and, you know, just, we never sort of became, like, friends or anything, but, like, we just had that one thing in common where, you know, we were both, like, in the same industry. have his whole hat sort of moving. I think that's the best way to make this look as dynamic as I can. So this particular style of animation takes ages to do. That's why it's great to look at. But it's extremely time consuming to produce. And there's a name for it too. I can't remember exactly what the name it, what its name is. It's got like a French name. The French. interestingly enough, like one of the biggest producers of hand-drawn, like just animation in general, outside of the United States and Japan. Yeah, my first bit of work experience was at a. Now let me just check if my. Yeah, everything appears to be fine. Yep. So these guys, their channel, well, they didn't so much have a channel because this was actually back during the 90s, late 90s, sort of, I guess you can call it. They'll sort of alternate between these different hats. Okay, so we've got this hat and this hat. Make sure we've got the color. Up the volume on that color. Yep. Ooh, wrong layer. probably should keep these separate. So I remember the videos I had back in the day. It's kind of like, if you've ever seen Paranorman, it was a bit like that. It was a fun little movie by Leica. This. So essentially what I want to do is have this hat as opposed to that hat. So get rid of that layer. Basically get rid of this tassel. This hat and replace it with the new one. So the hat looks like I want to keep the main body of the character kind of like as still as a rock. So like everything else like made of cloth that's on him sort of like moving dynamically in the storm. Starting to come together. Just make sure I've got a copy of that layer as well. Oh, just over there. Only the 40-minute mark. Significantly better than last night's, where I was battling a lot of amazing, super awesome, and fun technical issues. Get rid of his hat again on this one. And actually, get rid of this too, and use this as the sort of the template for the rest of the animation. Sort of work in around. I was watching this thing earlier today about established titles. Apparently, the whole thing was apparently a scam. And it got me thinking about, like, you know, certain sponsorships and everything. And I was just genuinely shocked. Well, not so much genuinely shocked, like, it kind of made sense that was going to be a thing. Because the whole premise of you know, selling the land of established titles just had a sort of almost a too good to be true kind of element about the whole thing. Every time I saw, like, the ads for established titles, I just thought, who would want that anyway? Like, it's a square foot of land on a country that, you know, even the people of Scotland are not exactly inclined to visit on a regular basis. Like, I mean, it blew my mind as enough that the land actually existed. Like, how many people are, like, signing up for that kind of stuff? Just, that's just wow. Apparently it's Thanksgiving in the US at the moment. That's pretty cool. Like, we don't celebrate Thanksgiving at all in Australia. But for some reason, we're expected to participate in Black Friday. Which, you know, without, like, Thanksgiving as a sort of a basic setup, the whole premise doesn't really make any sense. These two layers. Separate these out. That tastes a bit funky. See how this these layers flow together. So the motion lines are not necessary, but they help sell the effect. Because that's essentially what you want to do with basic hand-drawn animation. is it's all the illusion of movement at the end of the day. Excuse me. Add a frame in between each one of these. It's a bit more dynamic. Although now that I think about it, it actually makes it more slow moving. You kind of want to have like the strobing effect of like the light. Every time the lightning strikes, I want to have like the undulations of the fabric. These sort of template versions of Stay Puft, as so I can just sort of overlay the animated portions on top. Just simple frames, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate the entire job. So each version of Stay Puft will have a different version. Of each tie and each collar and each hat. Excuse me. One, we got duplicate, we got two, we got duplicate, we got three. So I'll turn these guys off. Thank you. layer these over the top. Careful. So this is your basic flood fill. It's a great thing about using Procreate. Versus Photoshop, because flood fill actually just means flood fill, which is immensely annoying, because I'm used to using a much older version of Photoshop, which basically had all those sort of like intuitive features that weren't like moved around. It's the main reason why I don't do a lot of Photoshop stuff live. It's just a pain in the butt, really. Cool. Now, same thing. The color palette for Stay Puft is pretty basic. Actually, I could just duplicate this and overlay hit the 1 hour mark.
on that background, just so I know. I still need to erase. Look a little bit more dynamic. Sort of have it flashing in the background. Ooh, what's going on here? Yeah, I realized that without the hat and the neckerchief, Mr. Stay Puft basically looks like an angry Baymax from Big Hero 6. This animation style is it's mostly for like GIFs and stuff, because that's essentially what I'm building towards, is kind of putting together a brand new animation portfolio, because I kind of want to have not just the the time-lapse drawings happening in the background, but also like a series of like animations as well.
I didn't get that. Could you try again?
Go away, Siri. You'll have to excuse me. I am using my Mac as my main streaming. And when I said series, Siri thought it was me talking to Siri. Siri, go away.
Okay.
Thank you. Oh boy. That was mildly embarrassing. Separate.
always have to be careful to just sort of like double check how the artwork's actually coming together. Quick scrub, see how that looks. Anyway, we are officially just over the hour, so I'm gonna take a short break. I will be right back. Thanks for sticking with me for the first part. Back in a jiffy. Thanks for bearing with me. Let's get straight back into it. Okay. Where did I put those hats? Where did I put those hats? Did I end up deleting? Oh, I must have. I'm a bit of a duffer. Oh, wait, here they are. Silly. I need to transport this one from here to here. Soda. So what else is new in the world? This is going to have to be my baseline. Gotta make sure the layer is visible. Fix up those other hats. got some fresh announcements. I will be live at Canberra Oz Comic Con next year. That should be fun. Now, fingers crossed it stays as unseasonably warm as it did this year, but it's anyone's guess. Line. Neckties a little further down. Yeah, I've got a reasonable suspicion that I'm not going to need all of these sort of like near as much like violet fluttering. I just need basically three. Oh hey, how's it going? Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good, pretty good. My chat is currently a little bit not working on my computer, so I've had to watch everything through my phone. So it is it's a little bit difficult at the moment. But how are you guys going? Oh, fantastic. Yes. Yeah, I'm back from sort of a brief hiatus. My voice is still a little bit affected because I had COVID for the second time in 2 years, so I'm a little bit prone to coughing and clearing my throat. But yeah, it's great to get a raid after all this time. You guys are Ghostbusters fans? Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. It's a funny old time of year because we're coming into summer and everything here in Australia, and everything's back open again, and the virus in whatever form it's currently taking is unfortunately still a thing. That's awesome. Yeah, this one, it was like a holdover from Halloween. I did like a sketch jam live stream of my work, just sort of like just drawing various different like horror theme stuff. And yeah, this one proved to be kind of a favorite, so I decided to like see if I could animate it into like a proper GIF. So I've got like a full-on background and everything, and I'm gonna see if I can make it look really cool, like effects and whatnot. I appreciate that. So how's you guys' raiding going? I haven't actually been on a raid in months myself. Last time I joined when I wasn't entirely sure what to do, but yeah, it'd be great to jump on board next time I've got bit of free time on my hands. Let's do a quick scrub back and forth. So it's slowly coming together. Fantastic, yeah. Look, I mean, that's kind of the great thing about raids as well, because it honestly doesn't feel nearly as like, oh my god, am I like talking to myself for hours and everything? And like, honestly, I don't mind because it sort of helps me sort of like go through the various thoughts, and like I can sort of work on scripts sort of like live and everything. But yeah, it's great to have somebody to like, you know, bounce ideas off as well. Yeah, is my music up high enough? I can barely hear it. It's very low, but like I kind of like it ambient. Scribbling. Ooh, yeah, that's not looking great. Yeah, this is Procreate animation, so it's very much in the like old school kind of way that they used to animate on paper. This is more of a demonstration as well as a potential portfolio piece that I'm working on. The basic premise behind it is I kind of want to like, if you've ever seen like animes of like a character standing like basically by themselves in a field of like tall grass or like, you know, wheat or whatever, and like you see what's it called, like just sort of a breeze just going through and like moving like the stems of the grass and everything, and like their hair moves and their clothes kind of move a little bit. That's basically the effect I want to reproduce with this. But like, this is like the coming of Gozer in Ghostbusters, so I kind of want to make it look more like dynamic, and there's a storm on the way. At least that's the basic premise.
Starport Mall is one of the finest shopping facilities in America and beyond. So come on down and remember, Starport Mall has it all.
Yeah, I'm just hot fixing as I go. Make sure to color code these just in case I get like a little bit confused as to which frame is on which layer. Now, it does look like kind of a hodgepodge at the moment, but I promise you the effect I'm trying to achieve here is going to look really cool. At least least that's the aim. It's been so long since I've done this kind of animation. But I've still got a knack for it. Hey there, how's it going? Yeah, I'm working on like a series of like different, like I'm gonna be making more GIFs down the track, not just like sort of like recognizable characters, but also sort of more, I guess you can call them like original-ish characters as well. Because I wanted to do one for Pennywise the Clown, but I straight up ran out of time because I wanted to have it ready for Halloween, and that never eventuated. Due in no small part to the fact that I got sick at the time, but you know how it is. Ooh, what have I done? That's getting there. Turn that layer. And the other main problem is you can easily run out of layers quite quickly on this as well. Hey there, how's it going? Turn off this layer here. Or rather the group and everything. Guys had a good night tonight, or day, or not entirely sure what time it is. Like when I first started going live, like some of the first people that would watch me were in the States, and I realized that it was like 4 a.m. over there. I'm like, man, what are you doing up so early? It's just like, I can't sleep, and your wonderful voice was the only thing that was able to get me to doze off, and like, thanks, I think. A compliment is a compliment, even if it's backhanded. Let's get rid of all of this. just need the layer with the hat color, and that's it. Everything else can be sorted out later. I think I missed a bit down the bottom. That should do it. Pop this on his head. Rather unceremoniously. Just gonna fill in the blank bits. Yeah, the boiling effect. That's the correct terminology for the animation style that I'm going for. It's called boiling, and it's particularly pervasive in stop motion, particularly like Fantastic Mr. Fox. If you've ever seen that, because the stop motion puppets that were used were covered in fur, unfortunately the boiling effect is really, really noticeable, and it actually makes the whole movie look pretty awful. Like, it just makes the whole thing very difficult to watch, because you're just noticing, like, how the hair or the fur on, like, Mr. Fox and, like, all these, you know, woodland creature friends is just constantly in motion. Like, I don't mind Wes Anderson's movies, but when he tries to do animation, it just looks like cheap and awful. And not in a good way either, because, like, you know, a lot of the time, like, really cheap, tacky animation can sort of have a so bad it's good quality, but then, like, you know, you've got, like, all these like, A-list celebrities doing, like, voice work, and you can't, like, spend, like, some of that money that you spent on getting, like, George Clooney on the animation budget. It just doesn't make sense. It's really sad, too, because, like, you can sort of see so much potential in a movie like that. Yeah, no worries. Thank you very much for dropping by, guys. I do appreciate getting a raid. It's very cool. And yeah, thanks again. Actually, I know what I'm going to do. It's looking a slight bit less messy. This looks like it's me and the lurkers once again. Seriously, thank you so much for coming in for the raid, if you're still around and would like to follow my future endeavors, making stuff for the internet. Yeah, feel free to give me a follow. Obviously no pressure or obligation to do so. It's kind of what I like about like Twitch and YouTube and platforms like this. It's there's something simultaneously amazingly like chilled out and relaxing, and also sort of intimately, I guess you can call it, like, mutual admiration from, like, a distance. And we kind of realize that we're all in the same boat, to some degree. As I round out to the 2 hour mark, I've got to say that I am very happy with how tonight's stream has gone. It's a sort of got to be in it to win it kind of element to this. Just gonna take another short-ish break. here, and I shall be back shortly with what I like to call part three. I'll be right back. Alrighty. Okay, well, I'm back, and this is part three, and it will be the final live stream. Typically, I only go to like an hour to an hour and a half, but this is sort of like a rare time before the Christmas rush where I can essentially do more. This is a project that I've had kicking around for like original title. This is Taser Swift. As you could say, part of a series of celebrity caricatures. It's kind of where I got my start, and I figured I may as well finish out tonight with this one. Whatever. She's a genuinely nice person, though I haven't never met her like myself. The whole idea behind this particular caricature is kind of make her look a bit like a weapon. I think I only like one Taylor Swift song, and that's Shake It Off, because I think that's the only like major big hit that she's had that I think like is universally just loved. Like, she's got some other ones, but I haven't been like keeping track of her career at all. But it does honestly feel like she's been famous forever. It's kind of a weird phenomenon where like you can go back, you know, over a decade and extremely wise and calculated moves, and she's surrounded herself with some, you know, basically the shore. The Kardashian family as well, like, they seem to have. You've just had everything hasn't really fallen into place. The worst possible thing you can do is go onto Celebrity Net Worth, because that's a sobering view. Then again, there are some famous people out there who have made an absolute pig's ear of their personal life. Just because somebody has been famous forever, that's like never gonna change. And quite often, like, you know, kind of changing now. Like, it's slow, but it is, like, you know, you're sort of seeing TV and movie stars are becoming sort of increasingly rare. Thousands are kind of like the pinnacle. There's really nowhere else to go. Especially when, like, everything sort of became way more accessible. So it sort of reached its kind of, its zenith during the pandemic, like, because we were all home and everything. Yeah. So I do have some, I guess you could call them announcements for the next stream I'll be doing. I probably will go live again tomorrow. I want to get really back into the habit of, you know, just really making stuff that's really cool, just putting it out there and seeing how it flows. So as you can probably tell, I was working on this long before I started this particular live stream. Never mind. Well, anyway. I can't believe my phone was unplugged this entire time. So I'll be doing a new sketch jam for December. Suggestions and requests. We'll be starting with like a basic theme and sort of like developing the ideas from there. And I come to the pretty much the end of the stream. I would like to thank everyone who rated, lurked, or you know, just accidentally clicked on this video and was like, sticking around for about a minute and a half and realized I wasn't. Just announced that coming up, we've got another, what's it called? Another sketch jam and another like animation that I'll be working on. I want to sort of alternate between different until next time. For some upcoming famous face jobs, I'll be drawing caricatures as well. Soon, but until then, I'd like to extend my very heartfelt appreciation to everyone who dropped by, and I will be back potentially tomorrow. I haven't made up my mind yet because there's like a lot of Christmas work I've got to take care of. So yeah, until then, I'll see ya.